Financial Sense Insider is a premium subscription service of PFS Group. The following is a free preview of today's Insider interview.
Economists get a bad rap, and probably a lot of that has to do with the fact that their forecasting record is not the greatest. And we have to admit that there is a little bit of problem with some of the data that they use. A lot of times it's given out after a very long delay. There's a lot of revisions in many cases with the data. So that puts economists in a difficult position where they are having to forecast the present. Weather forecasters, of course, they can just look outside, look at the Doppler radar and see what's going on right now. But with economists, they have to use data that may be released today, having to do with something that took place months ago, and then having to forecast what's taking place now. This is changing with the use of big data and what's referred to as nowcasting. And to speak with us about this, Jon Hartley is the co-founder and CEO of Real-Time Macroeconomics, and he's also a economics and finance contributor for Forbes and several other media outlets. He also worked at Goldman Sachs and at the Federal Reserve prior to that as well. Jon, thanks for coming on, and I want to ask you about this move that we see with big data and how it's revolutionizing the collection of economic information and some of the changes that we see taking place with companies and even at the high academic level, and let's say with government agencies. What's the big thing that you think, this big transformation that you see taking place?
Well, thanks, Chris, for having me on. I couldn't agree with you more that there is very much a big data revolution that's happening in economics, and it's manifesting itself in a few different places. I can give you a little bit of background and motivation behind creating real-time macroeconomic indicators using online data and how we do it at Real-Time Macroeconomics. In particular, we focus on creating real-time labor market statistics. But prior to that, while working at Goldman and their asset management division, I made this observation about really the critical importance of getting data that's timely. And one thing that I noticed that I started following pretty extensively while I was at Goldman was something that was started nearly 10 years ago, actually, called the MIT Billion Prices Project. And that measures inflation using daily prices of real goods from websites like Amazon, Walmart, online bookstores like Barnes & Noble. They have their own online bookstore. As Roberto and Alberto, the two MIT professors who started the project, found that this method of scraping online data works very well in tracking the BLS CPI inflation series. So that really was, I think, the first kind of breakthrough that told us that really online data has something to offer and something that's very valid and can closely track the official data. And better yet, they can provide that data almost on a real-time basis ahead of the official BLS government data release. Now, thinking about that innovation of having access to real-time macroeconomic data like inflation, that's very useful for financial market participants who create their own inflation models or trade tips or other inflation-linked securities. That's very useful for macroeconomists whose job it is to accurately forecast those numbers. And it's very important for policymakers like those at the Fed whose job it is to make economic policy decisions based upon the best data that's available. Now, while at the time these real-time inflation indicators were available, you know, no company or startup was offering anything like real-time labor market indicators. So that's where we saw an opportunity to create something new that could be useful to the previously mentioned groups of financial market participants, macroeconomists, and policymakers. I think there's a very much growing interest in new indicators like that, that they can obtain ahead of the official government BLS indicators. So I think there's certainly a demand for it. And I think it's not just changing the way that we react and respond to data, but also how we think about data on a more granular level.
It's interesting because I know that a lot of the data that's collected nowadays, you know, it comes from online. When we're talking about big data and how we take in this information and then measure it. Of course, most people think of online data, like you mentioned, Amazon. You know, there's a lot of different sources that we can use that's all available through prices online. But then, of course, there's other ways that are completely outside of the box in how this data can be acquired as well. And that's through the use of like satellite imagery or iPhone pictures, people snapping pictures of prices. And I know these are some of the things that have been mentioned that I think are really fascinating because, you know, it's kind of bypassing the conventional methods or even the conventional participants of how this information is measured. And I guess that's kind of where the aspect of getting it directly from the source and not having to necessarily just have a person, which, correct me if I'm wrong, but for decades now, maybe it's been this way for even longer, it's really amounted to a person going out and going into a store and writing down all the different prices. And that's kind of the way it's been done with the BEA and through the government. But big data, it's direct. I mean, it's real time, like you say. It's coming straight from the source.
Hi, everybody. John Leffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's Financial Sense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.